I plead the blood of Holy Yahushua over this video and over the mind, body, and spirit of every child of Yah watching this video in Yahushua HaMashiach's holy name.
Incredible job. Through Operation Warp Speed, we have three vaccines in the final stage of clinical trials. Yesterday, Pfizer announced, I just spoke to the head of Pfizer, great guy, they announced that it expects to have the results of its trial very, very shortly, next month. But very shortly, we remain on track to deliver a vaccine before the end of the year and maybe even before November 1st. We think we can probably have it sometime during the month of October. And Pfizer is among the leaders, as you know, and it's a great company. Johnson & Johnson also doing very well. Moderna. We have some really great companies. They're all doing very well. They're all in final stages. And I think you're going to see results that are shockingly good.
Shabbat Shalom, priests, and welcome back to Wakefulness Theology. My name is Messenger Aliyah Ora, and we're back with another exciting episode of Holy Yahushua's Name. So much to share with you, but before we start, please, those who are new to this channel, you need to catch up. In order to understand what we're talking about, you absolutely need to catch up. So the way to do that is to go to this video here. It explains what Wakefulness Theology is. And after that, go to the website, and here you can see all of our videos are put into playlists. This is the way Holy Spirit has taught us over the past 3 years. You must go in order to be built up. The information, it builds up, it repeats, just like school. It's like a school, a training for the end times prophets, the end time warriors, his bridal army, the anointed ones. That's what this is. So please be obedient. And if you're called and chosen to do this work, please go back and catch up. Let's get started. So this that we're talking about today is a very controversial topic. And it is a topic that is and has already divided the church. Now, as a part of the first menorah for Judah, this cannot and will not continue in the true church. So there is a division. There has been, and there will be a division between the apostate church and the true church. The true body of Christ will be coming out of the apostate church. And the line in the sand is being drawn right now, okay? So this is what we need to talk about. Like I said, it's very controversial. There's a lot of you who might have been following this channel for a long time, and you might decide that you don't want to follow anymore. This might be the straw that broke the camel's back for some of you. I pray not. I pray that what we discuss here, you take directly to the Most High Father, and you get your confirmation from him. But when I say it, take it to the Most High Father, I don't mean lightly. I don't mean like while you're going to eat dinner and before you say your grace, you know,
thank you, Father, for this food I'm about to eat. Show me if what she said is true.
And you just keep it in your dinner. That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about a real, really, really go after this. Like, you might need to fast. You might need to do an hour or so praise and worship service where you're putting on the worship music and you're at home by yourself and you're worshiping and worshiping until you're crying and you fall on your knees and you put your face down on the ground and you go prostrate and you beg and plead for him to show you this. That's how you need to be finding out this information, because this information is life and death. And when I say life and death, I'm not only talking about your earthly body. I'm talking about eternal life and death choices here, not only for you, but for your family, for your friends, for your community, and for your loved ones. Are you with me on the severity of this conversation? Please do not take it lightly. Please, in Yahushua HaMashiach's holy name, please do not take this lightly. Please don't be like throwing this into the pot with everybody else. In our minds as humans, we have a set reality there, okay? So you're born and then you're molded into whatever your reality is. Whatever that is for you, that's what it is. And it's set, it's your hard disk like a computer. You have your disk drive, you have your hard disk, and all the information that's coming in, it goes through your hard disk. And it's like things that support your programming can stay and build it. Things that don't support your programming, you just throw it out, right? You can't deal with this information that way, because this is new information that nobody on planet Earth who is currently alive has had the experience of before. We're not talking about what happened in the past. We're talking about the end times, the time that has never been seen before nor will ever be seen again, the times where if it were possible, even the elect would be deceived. That's what we're talking about. So you can't take this information and put it through your old disk drive with the old outdated information that you have had in the past. We're talking about a new day, okay? So you got to, before you even get up in here, okay, you need to take your hand like this, okay? Okay, this is the old disk drive that you had. You need to put it right here to the side for a minute. Just set it right here on the table. It's not going nowhere. When you're finished with the video, you can pick this up and you can put it right back on. It's still going to fit. It's still going to be working. It's right there. You're not going to lose it. It's right there. Okay? You put that to the side for a minute. You take in this new information. You pray on it. Seriously take it to the Father. You might have to fast. You might have to do serious worship. You need to really take this to the Father. And then you judge for yourself. All right, that's where we at with this. And anybody who's doing less than that, God bless you. Yah bless you. I wish you the best, you and your family. Yah bless you. Holy Father, please send them mercies upon them and their family. In Yahushua HaMashiach's holy name we pray, Amen. All right, I'm being obedient. So let's get to it. The only reason I'm talking about this topic is because I received a dream. And I was told and I was shown in the dream that I'm supposed to talk about this. If it was not for that, I wouldn't do it. I was commanded to talk about this. So let's hear the dream.
I just realized I've been dreaming about my ex-boyfriend Mark for like the 3 nights in a row. I've dreamed of him before, but these dreams are different. You all know that he was murdered. And this is a big reason why I'm here. Like, it was a huge traumatic event in my life that put me where I am now. But the dream that I've had these past 3 days are completely different than any dream I've had before. It was like I was with him in the dream, like we were together, and we had gotten back together in the dreams. And we were just living our life, and I was like, when I woke up, I'm just trying to understand why I'm having these dreams about him again. And last night, his mother came. We dated for years. We were really close, you know, like on the edge of getting married. And his mother was in the dream, and she called me and she said, "Oh, you've changed." And she recognized that I have changed. And I had learned that Mark's name was now CV. Now, CV in Europe means a resume. So when you have a job resume, a job interview, you give them your CV, which is European for a job resume. And so when she told me that Mark's name was CV, I was like, CV? Like, you know, it's not CB, it's not TB, it's not, you know, CV. No one is named CV. So I was like, okay. And, you know, the dream was all over the place. I can't even understand what the whole thing was about. But when I woke up, you know, that stayed with me. The fact that, you know, Mark was there again. His mother came and recognized that I had changed. And he had changed his name from Mark to CV. Right? So I'm still in bed. I, you know, just kind of scrolling through YouTube, scrolling through the Facebook, you know, before I wake up and get out of bed. And then I saw a video that is talking about the coronavirus and it's written CV. So that's when I realized CV is not talking about a resume in Europe. It's talking about the coronavirus, CV, the coronavirus. It's confirmation that the coronavirus is the mark. His name is Mark. Oh my gosh. I believe that that was confirmation, my personal confirmation that the coronavirus is the mark. This whole thing about this coronavirus is the mark. Okay, guys, I don't know what you want to do with that, but I believe that that was my confirmation. All glory to the Most High Father, holy is Yahushua.
The ones that I wrote above were the parts, the messages I wrote above is what I could catch in each of the, during the night. But the dream about we should pray because we must pray because our deliverance is near, that's for everybody. That's not just for me. That was made clear in the dream. We need to be praying because our deliverance is nigh. I assume that the deliverance is not going to be, you know, like butterflies, because when a baby is born, it's violent. Yeah. And you have the water breaking, you know, the water of the woman breaks. Well, if we're being delivered like a baby is being delivered, then it might have to do with the water event. I don't know. I'm just saying that it's a good thing because it's our deliverance. But I think it's going to be turbulent. So we need to pray. That's what I'm understanding from that. The other point is the Trump thing. He showed me a lot about Trump. He showed me how I'm supposed to talk and explain about Trump. I didn't catch it. I believe it's in my spirit. And what I mean is I didn't catch it mentally, but I believe it was put in my spirit. And what I can just say quickly now about it is that I don't need to argue about him being the Antichrist. That is neither here nor there. That has nothing to do with anything at this point, because we know at the end times you have all kind of Antichrists leaders that will be coming and doing, you know, all kinds of stuff. So it's beside the point. That's not the point. Whether it's him or Obama or whatever, that is not the point. The dream was explaining to me that I don't need to deal with that at all. The point is that he is the bad man. Point. We understand what a bad man means from that Psalm verse that I showed. And anyone who is going to the Holy of Holies cannot be supporting a bad man. It's written in the Holy Text. The other thing is that I saw myself talking about Trump in the dream. I saw myself talking about him releasing the vaccine in November. I didn't see him releasing the vaccine. I saw myself talking about the fact that he has said he will release the vaccine in November. So this goes directly against everything that we believe as Christians. We are not to be taking the mark. And so if you believe that the mark, the vaccine, is a part of the mark, and Trump is the president, not any other president. He is the one who will be ushering it in, because he made sure to do it before the election, just in case he wasn't reelected, which we all know he probably will be reelected. But just in case he isn't reelected, he made sure to make sure that it was him that did it, right? This is in direct contradiction to everything that the people are saying about him. He is the bad man. If you support him, you will be putting yourself in danger of losing your crown and possibly taking the mark of the beast. This is serious stuff. You will be blocked. You will be worshiping Moloch. This is where this is going. Okay, so as you can see here, there's a lot to chew on, and we don't have a lot of time. I only have an hour to get you guys this information, or at least to urge you, let the Holy Spirit urge you to look into this more for yourself, because I can't give you all the information in 1 hour. I'm going to come back to Trump. We just got to take this step at a time, okay? So I'm going to come back. We were talking about Naphtali last week, and we talked about everything here, authority, Moses' staff, and being under his protection, and we showed the hand movement. So the only thing we haven't talked about here yet is judgment. That's what this video is about. It's about knowing what it means to judge, knowing the difference between being a hypocrite, judging as a hypocrite, and judging righteously. And this is what we need to do right now as the body of Christ. Years ago, when I started this ministry in 2015, I was a whole different person. It's so funny when you look back, think for yourself who you were in 2015 and who you are now. It's just like we're different people. We were born again in Christ, you know. In 2015, I didn't know any of this. I received my audible command to start writing in December 2015. My cousin died at the end of 2015, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. And the night that he died, I received an audible message that said, as clear as I'm speaking to you, it said, in 12 weeks, the bad man comes. I've been talking about this for years. This is something you can look back in my videos and have the whole explanation and see it documented from the beginning. Actually, I believe it's one of the first videos I did on this channel. 12 weeks from that day was April 19th, and we've explained in detail about the importance of the date April 19th in past videos. Please catch up and you'll see that work. It's a high satanic day for Satanism, and there's a lot of tragedies that happen on or around that time. That day, April 19th, 12 weeks and 12 months from that day that my cousin died and I heard that message, Trump won New York. So prophetically, when it says in 12 weeks, weeks can also be months. So literally to the date, he won New York. And that's when everyone said that he could win the presidency, because before that time, no one was taking him seriously. But after he won New York, he was a serious contender. So that's when he was announced on the scene that day. So the message again was, in 12 weeks, the bad man comes. So this, for anyone who is truly a follower of Christ, you know that this is true because it was prophesied and it came true. That's how you know it's true. That's how you know it's not false, because it actually came to pass. Okay. So Trump is the bad man spoken of in that message that I received. Okay. Y'all can try to prove that it's not true, but it's documented. It happened. Okay. Just speaking as friends, like pretend like we don't have all this Christian stuff and all. We're not religious, or we're not talking about doctrine. We're not talking about religion. We're not talking about none of that. We're just two friends. We're at the bar and we're having a beer and we're talking about Trump. Okay. This would never happen because I don't drink, but you know what I mean. Just let's just go into the world. So we're there, we're chilling after work, happy hour, had a hard day at work, and we're just looking at the game on TV and we're just talking about Trump. Would anybody disagree that he's a bad man? Nobody's going to disagree with that. I don't need to spend hours talking about how his personality, not his politics, not none of that, his personality, he's a bad guy. He knows that. Everybody knows that. Can anybody disagree with that? He's a bad guy, right? He's not a good guy, meaning living in his ivory tower, toilets of gold, the vulgarity that comes out of his mouth, and just, I could just go on forever. I don't think I should have to spell this out for you guys. He's a bad man, right? When you look up a synonym for bad, you're going to find right here, you see, this is an English thesaurus dictionary, and you see it says vile. Okay. Now, when I found this, I wasn't actually looking for this. This came up because of the dream, right? So I saw, when I was looking through this, I saw the word vile, and that's when it clicked. You know why? Because it clicked because I've been reading Psalms 15 and 22, 101 and Psalms 91. I've been reading those Bible verses because in a dream, I was told to read those Bible verses for prayer protection, for protection. I have to show you guys, all of this because I want you to know this is not coming from my own heart or my own mind. This is coming from heaven, and out of obedience, I'm sharing this message with you. It's important to understand this. So I was given on July 21st at 4:49 a.m., I had a dream, and it said that we were singing in groups so that each of us should be prayed over. We have to read 55 and 22 and 101 as protection before we sing His holy name. So that's what I've been doing. I've been reading in the mornings, you know, sometimes Psalms 15, sometimes 22, sometimes 101. I've been mixing it up. And so when I had the dream, and then I went to see, I just looked at the word bad, and I saw vile, and in one and one clicked. As I was reading Psalms 15, when you read down, this is talking about who shall abide in thy tabernacle, who shall dwell in thy holy hill. So we've been talking about going up to the mountain and going into the temple. That's what we've been talking about. That's what we're doing. We're making our aliyah. Yes. And so then it's saying, who is going to go? He that walketh uprightly, worketh righteousness, speaketh the truth in his heart. He that backbiteth not with his tongue, nor doeth evil to his neighbor, nor taketh up a reproach against his neighbor, in whose eyes a vile person is condemned, but honoreth them that fear the Lord. So that's when it clicked for me. The problem with Trump, as far as being Christian, not even Christian, as far as being a priest, someone who is making your aliyah to the temple, someone who is singing his holy name. We're talking about the two anointed ones. We're talking about the bridal army. We're talking about the 144,000. These people here. This is what we're talking about, the called, the chosen, the elect, the true body of Christ at the end of the age, not the apostate church. These people, true spiritual sons of Yahuwah, you cannot support a vile person, point and blank. I was told Trump is the bad man, and nobody can argue with the fact that he is, you cannot say he's a good man. We all know he's a bad man. I was directly told audibly, he is the bad man. It has been fulfilled, that prophecy, exactly to the day that I was told. This is documented. It is a fact. We look up the synonym for bad, and it means vile. And we can directly see in this Bible verse that I was told to read for protection directly, that it says, in whose eyes a vile person is condemned. Point blank, end of discussion. If you consider yourself a priest, you cannot support a vile person. Trump is the bad man. So I don't need to argue about who the Antichrist is. I don't need to do all of that. This is facts. You need to deal with these facts. Please take this to the Father in prayer. So we need to judge. We need to be able to judge righteously. If you are a priest, if you consider yourself a priest, you need to know how to judge righteously. So let's just take a minute to look at that, because it's right here in the 12:12 Naphtali Lamed. So by this time, 23:26, that is something that we should all have and know how to do. Okay, so let's look. Okay, so we need to, before we continue with the Trump point, we need to look at what is it to judge and how are we supposed to judge each other and you know, the world. So this comes from 1 Corinthians 6:2-5. Do you not know that the saints will judge the world? And if you are to judge the world, are you not competent to judge trivial cases? Do you not know that we will judge angels? How much more the things of this life? Therefore, if you have disputes about such matters, appoint as judges even men of little account in the church. I say this to shame you. Is it possible that there is nobody among you wise enough to judge a dispute between believers? So this is what we are supposed to do. We are supposed to learn this process here, us being on earth. It is a practice for us to learn how to judge, because we're going to have to judge the nations. Look, it's right here in black and white. You're going to have to judge the nations. Not only is it written here, Holy Yahushua has come to me and told me this more than one time. I don't know, maybe a couple of times. And he's reminded me that this is a part of our training. We have to learn to judge righteously. Okay? So if we can't judge here what's going on, if we can't look at Trump and judge whether he's a good man, a bad man, a vile man, or a righteous man, if we can't judge that, then we got a lot of problems. How are we going to judge the nations? So please take this seriously. Get out of your feelings about how you feel about politics and all that. We're not talking about none of that. Okay? We're talking about what heaven is bringing down for us to do. Another thing is that we do not judge by appearances, but we judge by righteous judgment. So what is righteous? What is right judgment or righteous judgment? It is accounted unto you because of your belief in Yah. So let's look. We also have the last point is we also have the fact that we must give an account on judgment day for every idle word we speak. The words we say will either acquit or condemn us. So we need to look at a few things. We need to look righteously. We cannot be hypocritical. That's when that verse that's talking about judge, lest ye be judged. That's talking about those who are being hypocrites. So we can't be hypocrites. We have to judge righteously, not by appearance. And we have to look at what is said with the person's own mouth, right? So let's do that in this situation. All I did was Google Trump is vile. That's it. That's all I did. And we have the Washington Post, Trump's vile tweet storm. Twitter, Trump is vile. I didn't put it. I have nothing to do with it. I just Googled it. Trump, this is just 3 days ago. Trump came to Kenosha to make the most vile. So look at how many times you have his name connected with the word vile. That's amazing. Vile slander, vile. It's like everybody knows. Now, let's not go on appearances. Let's look deeper and see, does he fit the criteria of righteousness, someone who actually believes on the Most High Father? So we can also look at his own words that he's actually said right here. Donald Trump, quote unquote, and I know I saw this video. You can look it up for yourself. I haven't asked Yah for forgiveness. I even put this in past videos. So he is someone who has not repented of his sins. I don't ask Yah for forgiveness. I haven't sought forgiveness, and he never will, according to him, because he doesn't think he needs to. So is that righteous? Do I need to put on the screen different verses that say that we have to repent for our sins? So this is unrighteousness. Is it or is it not? Judge. You'll be judging the nations. Judge. Is it righteous or not? This is the kicker. This is what the dream was telling me. The main talk point is that I need to get across to you. He is the one, not the president before him, not the presidents after him. He is the one that is bringing in the vaccine right here. 2 days ago, he's bringing in the vaccine before the presidential election. Just in case he isn't reelected, he wants to make sure that this is done. He's bringing in the vaccine. So all of you people who believe whatever you believe, you can keep all your beliefs that you want. But know this, it is him that is bringing in the vaccine. So now you have to ask yourself, we've finished judging. We have looked at the evidence and he is found wanting. He is a vile man and he is unrighteous. Therefore, we cannot support him according to Psalms 15. Right here, according to Psalms 15, anyone who is making your aliyah to the temple on the mountain, to the Holy of Holies, you can no longer support Trump because he has been judged a vile man. He has been judged by heaven, as I received in that prophetic message that has come true. He has already been judged a vile man. Therefore, those who go to the temple must condemn in your eyes, in your opinion, you must condemn a vile person. That's where that is. Take it to the Father and get your own confirmation. But you need to do so very quickly, because the next thing you need to judge for yourself is the V for vendetta the mark of the beast? And that's what I'm going to quickly talk about. But the information I have here is so much that I can't put it in this video. I'll show what I can, and you have to, on your own, do your research and look at these videos and look at this information. This is a video from Leland Jones. Now, a lot of you have unsubscribed to him because he was talking about Trump being the Antichrist, and you don't believe that, so you just threw the baby out with the bathwater. Well, I'm asking you to go back outside, go outside, pick up the baby, and put him back in the bath, and put the water back in the bath, because you left too soon. This brother right here, Leland Jones, is telling the truth. There are many antichrists with an S, and they're all working together. You have the 10 kings. You have the whole Satan's army coming together at the end times to bring in this beast kingdom. So it's not just one person. After Trump, there'll be someone else. After that person, there'll be someone else. And it's just going to keep going until it's done. So we're looking at the first person who's going to do it. Well, we can see he's the first person that's doing it because he's doing it. It is past tense at this point. He has done it. He is the one that changed Jerusalem. He is the one that is fulfilling these covenants. He is the one that is bringing about this one world religion and all of these prophecies. He is doing it. It has been, many of these prophecies have been fulfilled by him. If you just look. Okay, so whether you want to call him whatever you want to call him, you can call him, I don't care. You don't have to call him Antichrist if you don't believe he's the Antichrist. But you need to know that what he is bringing in is the mark of the V for vendetta is the mark of the beast. So what you will understand if you watch this video, and I pray that you watch this video, I'll put the link in the comments. He is explaining that the mark of the beast is not just one thing. It's just like us as sons of Holy Yahushua. It's not just one thing that makes us the son of Holy Yahushua. It's like all of these things we've been talking about all this time, about our diet, about observing the Sabbath, about following his commands, about getting rid of our kaka. All of these things, getting your new name, yada yada, all of these things make us the sons of Holy Yahushua. And then to top it off, we get a mark. We get sealed by Holy Father. That is our seal. The enemy has the same thing. It's not just one thing that makes you have the mark. It's many things. One of it is pharmakia. And that's where the V for vendetta. That's where the V for vendetta comes in. And then with that V for vendetta, there's going to be information on you because they're going to have to say who has had it and who hasn't had it. So there's going to be things, nanobots in that vein that's going to be able to mark you as someone who has been vaccinated. And then you're going to have some other kind of identification. So the V for vendetta. Those who have had the V for vendetta can buy and sell and live a normal life. Those who have not had the V for vendetta,
you won't. You won't be able to go to school. You won't be able to go to work. You won't, yada, yada. This is already happening. As you can see here on the screen, there's a sister in Christ who just said yesterday that she's a nurse and her job is making it mandatory for her to have the vaccine. We're here, priest. There's some of you still with your head in the sand thinking that we still got years and years. You need to catch up. It's here. If this sister does not take the V for vendetta, she will lose her job. This is where we're at. This is the defining line. And who is bringing this in? It is Trump. So if you're blindly following him, you will be taking the mark. If you are blindly following him and supporting him, you will not get into the Holy of Holies. You feeling me? Do you hear the gravity of this situation? So I highly suggest you watch this video, whether you have agreed with him in the past or not, with your old ideas. You need to let those old ideas go because they're obsolete now. This is a new day, a new world. We got a new thing going on. So all of the preachers in the past, all of the prophets and preachers or whoever that have taken a stand and said, Obama is the Antichrist, Trump is the Antichrist, such and such is the Antichrist, all of that is done now. You can close that door. That is done. The new day is this. Did you take the mark of the beast? Yes or no? Point. That's how you're going to know from this day on, as soon as it comes out. That's how you're going to know who the apostate church is and who the real church is. So you don't have to guess and you don't have to wonder much longer. Whoever takes this V for vendetta, that is part of the mark of the beast. You have been marked. And at that point, as Christians, you can no longer follow those people. So please, I'm asking you, please, to watch this video and you'll understand better about what the mark of the beast is. It also has to do with Sunday, the Sunday law. And you need to know about that because our Sabbath is Saturday, Friday, Saturday. It is not Sunday. Changing the Sabbath to Sunday was something the Vatican did, and it is Antichrist. And that is part of the mark of the beast. This video right here, I'll play a little bit because it's important.
Hi, this is Celeste, and this is a breaking news report on July 13th, 2020. And I just need you to know that the beast is here. And every word is weaponized and it is dual use for plausible deniability. So you're going to tell people these are the facts. And they're going to say, well, I just see the good part of this. And so there's going to be confusion, which, of course, that is a signature of Satan. But it is no wonder that people are under this obedience spell and kind of in a trance-like state. And so this system is going to be required, and you are going to be faced with it imminently. Testing, vaccination, and the sensory tracing, the 24/7 tracing that we've talked about before. And I just want you to know that as of last week, I have found that no matter what you do, if you get tested, either the saliva, the prick, or the blood, they are injecting you with the hydrogel quantum dot. And so you are getting dosed at the time of testing. It is just the way that it is. Of course, you will get maybe a second or a booster during your vaccination or multiple vaccinations. It remains to be seen how many vaccinations we're going to be having. And oh, let me back up for a sec. The testing, you are going to have to be tested about every 30 days. And so you're going to constantly be getting this hydrogel quantum dot injected into your body. And then, of course, the sensory tracing is the array. And we basically, the bottom line, when you do the testing, the vaccination, or let's say it's just a sensory, you agree to a sensor being placed inside your body to let public health know your health condition, it is injecting the DNA of Satan. It's probably the fallen angels, but basically their father is the father of lies, Satan. So that is what is getting injected into your body. And that what that does is it turns you from a human to something unrecognizable by the Lord Jesus Christ. And so, I mean, this is even for testing, much less the vaccination and the sensory. So you need to really be thinking seriously how you are going to stand. We are supposed to stand. We are supposed to oppose this type of a system. And it's more than that. Our eternal destiny is at work here. You need to understand that the coronavirus is not a virus like you know it. This is a nanoparticle, a biological synthetic particle that is hollow, and inside it can contain, its payload can contain like a virus, a fungus, a bacteria, parasites, chemicals, drugs, explosives, demons, spirits, and even fallen angel or giant DNA. Any of those could be in the payload, and they have a mission, and that mission can be a precision strike against you personally and your body, or it can be against like large numbers of people, like if they just wanted to get a particular ethnic race or people that were non-compliant, let's say to vaccines or something like that, they have the capability to do that. And then this allows plausible deniability, because there's a lot of confusion. Is it a virus? Isn't it a virus? We're saturated with these nanoparticles, and it is, I can't tell you, I am getting thousands and thousands of peer review articles talking about this technology, and they all confirm one another that this is what's happening, and it is why the people did not respond when they got coronavirus. They went to the hospital, they were in intensive care, and their lungs were filling up. The doctors assumed they had pneumonia. They didn't have, I believe now, that they did not have pneumonia. What they had were a combination of things. The nanoparticles swarmed in the lungs, clogging the lungs, causing some hemorrhagic action, when they swarm, they are multiplying in your body. They're like really like aphids in a way, and then the person just dies.
But the information was too time sensitive, so he needed to get that video up, and I decided to go ahead and mirror it on mine and add some visuals on my site so that people could hear what's coming down the bend. The documents describe tiny microcellular sized killing machines called nanites, because they have an outer coating that is robust and can handle going through the digestive system until they get to the right place to either burrow into human flesh or attach themselves to human flesh to go where they need to go. Now, the nanites that he's talking about are made for one simple purpose, and they are to burrow into the bloodstream, gain entrance to the brain and other areas of the body in order to attach themselves to that tissue and lay in wait for classified military frequency signal, at which time they manipulate the brain and other areas of the body to send signals to those other areas of the body to affect what is called a cytokine storm. It's a sort of immune system feedback loop that is like your immune system on steroids. They cause the body's immune system to turn against itself and mimic virulent flu-like symptoms that develop into upper respiratory infection, fluid in the lungs, pneumonia, and eventually death. Not only that, it's in vaccines. So these vaccines and so forth are laced with it. That's another interesting thing that we'll talk about.
Well, literally, we have the science, am I correct, to make these little nano machines that can do various tasks. Is that correct?
Yes, and they're made to order. So they get this frequency, and they get their working orders, they do their working orders, and then they report back what they've done when they're finished.
Unfortunately, I can't play the whole thing, but again, I'll leave the link for the video in the comments, and it's up to you to come here and get the information. Like I said, it is life and death. It really is. And some of you have already been tested, and you're going to have to pray on this. This one right here, I'll play a little bit of it, but it's up to you to come and watch the full video, because if you want to understand, then here it is right here.
So what do you think about going from human 1.0 to human 2.0? And what does that mean? Well, going from humans as we now know ourselves to human 2.0 has something to do with transhumanism. If you're not familiar with that term, it's about taking humans as we know ourselves and melding with artificial intelligence. Kind of like being in the Matrix, if you've ever seen that movie. However, this question, this idea is now right in this moment. We need to make a decision. And I found out that we need to make a decision about this because I investigated the proposed COVID-19 vaccine. And this is my alarm call to the world. I looked at the pros and cons, and it frightens me. I think that, some people that you might know these names, Elon Musk, who is the founder of SpaceX and Tesla Automotive, as well as Ray Kurzweil, who is one of the big wigs of Google. These are self-proclaimed transhumanists. They believe that we should go to human 2.0, and they are very big proponents of this. So for instance, Moderna is one of the front runners for the COVID-19 vaccine. You should know that Moderna was founded by a person from Harvard, Derek Rossi, and this researcher actually was successful in taking some modified RNA and being able to reprogram a stem cell in the body and change the function of the stem cell. He actually made it genetically modified, okay? So he proved that you can genetically modify something by using modified RNA. So they founded the company Moderna on this concept. It's kind of a new kid on the block, okay? It's not been around that long. In fact, it hasn't even made any vaccine for a human before. It's made no medicine for a human before. This will be their first run. And how are they doing this? Well, they're actually suggesting to use a platform. Let me just explain how they would administer the vaccine. So the vaccine, there's an idea called microneedle platform, okay? This was developed by MIT. And they said it could be very easily produced, okay, and mass produced. This is why they're proposing this technology, and many millions of vaccines could be made quickly. They could also be administered by yourself. So the idea is to get a Band-Aid. It looks like a Band-Aid you buy in the drugstore. It's shipped to you through Amazon or UPS or some other shipping service. You take it out of the package, you put it on your hand like this, and then you take the sticker off, and voila, you've been vaccinated. So how is that possible? Well, in this Band-Aid, it has little tiny spicules, little tiny needles, and this was designed after a snake viper fang bite, okay, or snake viper bangs, so little snake bites. Anyway, in these tiny little spicules, they claim you won't really feel it that much. There's their little hydrogel. It's a material called hydrogel. Inside the hydrogel would be a luciferase enzyme as well as the vaccine itself. Okay, so what is all that? So first of all, you're getting the vaccine. It's modified RNA or modified DNA. Let's take Moderna, modified RNA. So in that modified RNA, the idea is that the microneedles will puncture into your cell membrane, okay? And this synthetic piece of an RNA, it's a code for the part of the virus, or they could use a synthetic DNA to code for the part of the virus, would go into your nucleus, your body would start transcribing it, would start reading it, and making more of that part of the virus. Well, why would we want to make more of the virus or part of the virus? The idea is your body would get used to seeing it, would know how to make antibodies, and would have an improved T cell response. And the idea is then when you saw it in the future, your body would already know how to fight it and it would be a better response. That's the idea. The problem with that is they're using something called a process called transfection. And transfection is a way that we make genetically modified organisms. Okay, I think you know about those fruits and vegetables. They're not as healthy as the normal wild type fruit and vegetable. So possibly you could extrapolate that to a human. If we become genetically modified, we would not be as healthy, okay? We don't have long-term studies on this anyway. This is unbelievable. And, you know, the vaccine manufacturers have made the statement, this will not alter our DNA, our genome. I say that is not true. Because if we use this process to make a genetically modified organism, why would it not do the same thing to a human? They want to make sure that you're vaccinated. They don't trust medical records. They don't trust you saying that you got vaccinated. They want to make sure, and they want to make sure it was successful, a successful transfection, a successful gene modification. So when you get the luciferase enzyme, if you have an iPhone or a special app on the iPhone, you can scan over that area and it will give a digital code, a digital imprint, a digital pattern, something that will identify that you were vaccinated. It holds your vaccination record. It also gives you an ID, a number, a barcode, a branding, whatever you want to call it, a tattoo. It's all the same thing. You now become like a product. So we have that. Now the third thing I mentioned was hydrogel. So hydrogel is actually an invention from DARPA, the Department of Advanced Research Projects Agency. This is kind of a sci-fi kind of a group from the Department of Defense, Pentagon, of the US government. They make these fantastic inventions. So one of them is hydrogel. Hydrogel, you can YouTube, look on YouTube, look at Profusa is one of the companies, DARPA, as well as hydrogel, and you'll find some little 2-minute clips that they describe. So hydrogel is nanotechnology, microscopic little robots. And these little robots, actually, I know it sounds crazy, it's still crazy to me, but it's possible, okay? They can disassemble, reassemble, assemble into and make different things. So with this hydrogel, it's really nanotechnology. So that's something, robotic or something that's artificial intelligence. It has the ability to connect with artificial intelligence. So this means that a human can now connect to directly and gather information from our bodies and gather it and connect with your smartphone, with the cloud, with some other smart device. And once this is done, this is 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year.
And the last video, I'll play a little bit of it, but you're going to have to go and watch the full video yourself. This, again, a change is coming. Sister Shauna, she often confirms what I've received, and here she's confirmed it again, August 31st, right here, right here, right here. Please watch it.
Let me tell you something. I've said this before on my channel. Trump is not human. He's a demon in human form. I know that sounds crazy. And you may say, what on earth, Shauna? How can he be a demon in human form? I have discussed ways they are doing this, and I will put videos I've done about it in the description box because I've already talked about that in other videos. So you have to see them, but I'm telling you the truth. I'm not the only one that God revealed this to. There are very few of us that know these things. But, you know, I'll put another video of another lady who I did a video on, and she was shown the same thing. But I wasn't just shown it prophetically. I know it for a fact, like through a spiritual gift that, you know, very few people have. I can't go into that. But I'm telling you, I know for a fact he's a demon in human form. And when you pray for a demon like that, you create a soul tie with them. And they want you to pray for them, to curse them, to curse you, I mean. To curse you, to curse your dreams, to let them in. It's like opening a door. You open a door for them to be able to come in and curse you and curse your home, curse your, you open a door. They could try to curse you in all kind of ways. You don't want to pray for a demon. And I'm telling you, he has no human soul. He is a demon in human soul, in human form. And I had another dream about him recently, like maybe a month ago now. And I didn't post that dream because I couldn't remember the whole dream. All I know is in the dream, it was showing he has some kind of robotic parts in the back of his neck and head.
So with all of that said, let's look deeper at the dream that I had about Trump. And let's look up some of the holy letters. So this one right here, it said it's September 4th, 2020 at 8:22 a.m. So it was the end of my dream, and I was given the number 3434. So when you look up 3434, right here, it means people will return. People will return to worship Moloch. Right here. 3434, people will return to worship Moloch right here, right here, right here. Do you see that? So who is Moloch? Moloch is a Canaanite god associated with child sacrifice through fire and war. The V for vendetta is going to kill a lot of people. Just know it. It is going to kill a lot of people. And they're going to cover it up and say that it's whatever. It's the Rona. They're going to say what they want, but you know the truth. These people that are going to be killed . So if you still, after you watch this video, if you're still supporting Trump, that's what you're supporting right here. You're supporting that death and war. That's what you're supporting. Please know this. This is another message I received in my dream. It says, Holy Yahushua told me I have showed you the way. And then he gave me these numbers, 311-42 at 1:58 a.m. Now, 1:58 means to cause, or the cause is love. So the reason why this is happening, it is being caused by love. You can look it up yourself. It is because of love. That's why. He has shown us the way. 311 and 42. I don't have the time in this video to look it up. Maybe we'll come back another time and read the letter lines together. This is another message I received September 4th at 1:43 a.m. All of this was the same night when I was having that experience. My sea of chi. Do you guys remember we learned about the sea of chi, the continents of the Most High Father? So I'm starting to understand when I'm having these experiences now, it comes through emotion. And it's righteous indignation sometimes. Sometimes it's love, sometimes, but they're very powerful. Whatever the emotion is, it's very powerful, and it's always linked to kingdom business. You know what I mean? It's not like I'm mad because my favorite sport team won or lost or whatever. It's really connected to kingdom business. So this emotion, it gets so powerful, and then it stirs up my sea of chi. And that's when I have to move the energy around myself, or it just feels like it's going to, right? So this night, this is when I was receiving all these messages and these dreams. And one of it, it says, pray for your deliverance is nigh. So that's what Holy Yahushua told me. And I understood that it wasn't only talking about me. It's also talking about all of us. That's what I understood in that dream.
He's talking about all of us. We have to pray because our deliverance is nigh. So remember, we talked about this at the beginning of this playlist, how when a woman has birth, like Revelation 12, woman is birthing the son. Giving birth is violent. It's painful. And the woman's water breaks. So that's why we were comparing the birth with the water breaking with the water event that we're expecting. I don't know the details of this message, but what I'm trying to get you to understand is when he's saying here, pray for our deliverance is nigh, we have to pray because in order for us to be delivered, it's going to be turbulent. It's going to be upheaval. It's going to be violent. It's going to be earth shaking, shattering it. I don't, you know, let Holy Spirit give you the words to understand. We have to pray for all of us to get through this time because we, our deliverance is nigh. But when that deliverance comes, it's going to be a sight to behold. That's for sure. So priest, please pray for our deliverance is nigh. And when you look up 143, you see the time is 143 here. When you look it up, it says to perceive the 12th month in the Jewish calendar. So Adar is the 12th month in the Jewish calendar, and that is the new year for us. That is March, April time. So I don't know if this talking about our deliverance is nigh, if that has to do with March, April, probably because that's what we've learned in the past. So be ready. Because it could be this year, it could be March, April 2021. I don't know, but if it is, it would definitely line up. Either way, keep your spiritual armor on. Learn how to fight because we're in it. The enemy is doing a direct preemptive strike against us before we can mature into fully mature sons of Holy Yahushua, before we get our powers, before we know who we are. They're coming after us. Please know this. That's what all of this is about. All of this is about coming after us before we can come after them. Know this. Pray, for your deliverance is nigh. 12th month in the Jewish calendar. At that springtime, apparently, this is when we will be able to fully perceive and understand what's going on through your resonating sense of inner discernment. That's what that means. So the sooner you start preparing, the sooner you start getting with this, the easier and better it's going to be for you. Because when these things really start happening, remember, it's going to be so terrible or so violent or so out there that men's hearts will stop. So you need to be detaching yourself from this stuff. Let's look at this. Okay, so quickly, this is an episode from The Last Airbender. It's season 3. Anyway, as I said before, you should watch this cartoon. It really puts a lot of things into perspective and it'll help you understand a lot of these concepts. In this cartoon, he's explaining why supporting Trump or any politician from this point on, from this time in our lives as priests that are being trained on, if you do not heed this warning that we've received directly from heaven and you continue, you will be cut off from your ability to go further and mature into who Father wants you to be. To do what you're supposed to do. Please hear this. So this is when Aang is being trained. I'm feeling like this video is going to be too long. Priest, I'm going to stop here and we're going to talk next time about this avatar because it's too much for me to explain in this video. So next time we'll come back and we'll finish the point about the consequences of not fully submitting to what heaven has just commanded us to do, which is in Psalms 15, you in our eyes, we must condemn a vile person. This is important because we are to judge the nations. If we cannot judge, it's something that is so clear here on earth. How are we to judge the nations? And those who turn your back on this and you continue, you will be putting yourself in danger of taking the mark of the beast. You will be putting yourself in danger of politician worship, meaning Moloch, worshiping Moloch, because what is going to come from this vaccine is death, war, and destruction, and you will be supporting that, and that is considered worshiping Moloch. At the end of the day, what I want to show you about this, and I'll show it to you next week, we'll go more in depth, but this is the most important point. We are blocked by earthly attachments. You have to meditate on what attaches you to this world. Again, people are going to be all upset about the word meditate. We are directly commanded to keep our eye on Holy Yahushua, on his face. We are commanded to meditate on heaven and heavenly things. That means putting your mind going to heaven and to be communing with Holy Yahushua. This, we are commanded to do this. So please, again, do not lean on your own understanding, but take this to the Father. And you have to let go of these attachments. And this is what needs to be done in order for you to go up again to the next level. And if you do the, if you don't do this, you will be blocked. So what I want you to understand is this: depending on politicians and believing that they're going to save you, if you still believe that there's anything to be saved, first of all, Holy Yahushua is not coming to save this world. He is coming with a sword. That's why the evil ones are fighting so hard against it, because he's coming to destroy the wicked. So there's nothing to be saved. You can't save it. Nobody can save any of this. Only Holy Yahushua. The politicians can't save it. Nobody can save it. So as long as you continue to be attached to the world and the things of the world, you're putting yourself in danger that you probably will take the mark. Do you see what I mean? What they're going to say is that if you don't have the V for vendetta, then you can't live your life as you do now. Before that happens, you should already be disconnected from living your life as those other people do. You should already be disconnected. And in that way, you won't really be suffering as much when they force you to do it, because you'll already be disconnected. If you still have attachments, if you still believe in the political system, you still believe that you're going to vote and that's going to make a change for the better, you're still attached. If you're still going out and enjoying life in that way, drinking and smoking and having fun or whatever, you're still attached. You need to completely let go of all attachments so that this energy, the Holy Father's countenance, can flow through you. And until you do that, you will still be attached. And as long as you are still attached, you are directly influenced by the beast system and at high risk of taking the mark. I know a lot of you are thinking, I'm not going to do it, but when it comes down to it, and they're like, if you don't do this, you're going to lose your job.
You could end up homeless.
Your children won't be able to go to school. Do you see what I mean? Are you ready to crucify yourself for that, for Christ? That's what you're going to have to do. And if you're not willing to do it right now, if you're not able to stand up to your spouse right now, if you're not able to say no to the school system right now, if you're not able to say no to these political things going on right now, how do you think you're going to say no to the V for vendetta when your life depends on it, your current life depends on it? You'll take it. So this is truth. Please take it to the Father. Judge righteously and act accordingly. I love you so very much in Christ. I'll come back next week to explain better what I said at the end. I have to hurry up because of time. But I pray that you have understood. All glory to the Most High Father. Holy is Yahushua. Thank you, Holy Father, for protecting us during this time and keeping us safe. And thank you for delivering us. And may we all be resting in your arms of protection. And may we all be sent to the wilderness where we can rest and be fed until it is time for us to do what you have brought us here to do. All glory, praise, and honor to the Most High Father. Love you, priest. Shalom.